My name is Giancarlo Cotella, and I'm a professor of spatial planning at Politecnico di Torino, and I teach in the Master of Science in Territorial, Urban, Environmental, and Landscape Planning, which is what I will present to you today, and in particular, its English curriculum, which is titled Planning for the Global Urban Agenda. Some rules: I see that there are more people coming. You are entitled to ask questions. During my presentation, that will take around 20 minutes, you can write your question if something comes to your mind in the chat that you can see on the left, on your left-hand side in the red bar. You can add there specific comments. I think you are allowed, although there is a lock next to the icon. And my colleague that are here with us today, Professor Claudia Casatella and Federica Bonavero. Dr. Federico Bonavero will provide you with some answers, if possible, real time. If this is not too urgent, we will have a Q&A question and answer session as soon as I finish with the presentation. The presentation will be mostly informative and try to touch here and there all the interesting points and the important points of our curriculum. And we really hope that it interests you and that then you will apply and be with us. So, we are talking about the Master of Science in Territorial, Urban, Environmental, and Landscape Planning, and in particular on the Planning for the Global Urban Agenda curriculum. It is a normal Master of Science in the Italian panorama, accounting for 120 ECTS credit, meaning 2 years full time. Yeah, there is also possibility to follow part time, but the full time is for 2 years. The location where the lesson usually take place when it's possible to meet physically is the Valentino campus. I don't know if you're familiar with that, but it's one of the most beautiful places in Torino. It's in a castle in a very big park, and so on and so forth. The semester starts in September on the end on the 28th. This is very interesting. Yeah, we are going to meet very soon in case you enroll. The course, of course, is fully in English. Yeah. What is spatial planning, territorial planning, urban planning, and what is our take on it? Well, our take, and the name of the curriculum says it, Planning for the Global Urban Agenda, it's quite open to international comparison and perspective. Our idea is that planning is very context dependent as an activity, but planners cannot anymore do their job in their context without knowing what is happening in other places and other contexts, and how people, planners, are dealing with challenges all around the world. So we follow the most recent document produced by international organizations like UN Habitat, and here you have a picture from the New Urban Agenda of 2016. We follow in our curriculum the main indication and touch upon the main issues dealt with by main international organizations, and therefore the challenges that globally territorial development is facing. This means, for instance, climate change, for instance, the management of heritage, for instance, how to deal with the environment, environmental sustainability, energy transition, and so on and so forth. Our Master of Science is divided into two curriculum. I think that if you are, I suppose that if you are here today for the presentation in the English language, you are interested in the second one you see on the slide. It is the Planning for the Global Urban Agenda. But this is just a communication to tell you that there is also the Italian curriculum. And if you will be fluent in 1 year time in English language, you can also pick from some subjects that are taught in the Italian curriculum. The English curriculum is much more open to international view on planning, therefore preparing students also for being more prone to adapt to the international market, while the curriculum in Italian is more focusing, although it has still some takes still some inspiration on global issues, it is more focused on the Italian institutional, administrative, and professional environment. How does the curriculum is structured? Well, it is structured in 2 years, each structured in 2 terms or 2 semesters. Yeah, 2 semesters. You can see briefly here what are the courses and the subjects that are available and given to you in each of the semester. And if you click on the link below, Just parentheses, all the material I'm presenting today, plus many other materials and explanatory video and so on, are already uploaded on the Open Days page of our course and on the Polito page of our Master of Science. So you can go there and find all the documents in which you can click on the links, which is very important, so that you could see on this link the full account of the courses that we teach, the credits it gives, the curriculum and the syllabus of each of the courses, and so on and so forth. So for the first three terms, you mostly follow theoretical courses, meaning ex-cathedra courses in which you are provided and stimulated to acquire knowledge on specific subject. May it be transnational spatial planning, comparison, and so on. May it be landscape planning, maybe territorial management, may be other subject, yeah, environmental evaluation, and so on and so forth. In parallel to this acquisition of knowledge, you are required to apply the knowledge into real life experience, so in the practice, for what we call studios or atelier. In each of these studios or atelier, students acting either individually or in groups are required to apply the knowledge that they acquire in the theoretical courses into real life situations that are usually organized by the professor of the courses together with outside bodies, like for instance, public administration, like for instance, NGOs, like for instance, other public and private bodies that are dealing with territorial development and territorial management. So there is this twofold idea of acquiring and learning and applying the knowledge into the practice. This happens in the first three terms, which, by the way, offer you also the opportunity to choose between optional eligible module. So according to your preferences and to your sensitivity, you could choose what you want to specialize on. This is very important. If you are more interested into landscape, then you could apply to eligible subject from other Master of Sciences that are dealing with that. If you are more into sociology or economics and so on, you can apply to other subjects offered by Politecnico in a catalog of eligible courses. You can also apply if you're interested in the built environment and in more architecture-based subject, to subjects that are offered by the Master of Sciences in Architecture. This is really important so that you can customize your curriculum according to your needs and to your basically to what you want to do in the future. In terms four, so the second part of the second year, you will be required to develop a research. A research which takes the shape of a master thesis is a very important project process. It accounts for as much as 30 credits, meaning one fourth of your curriculum. It could be take two different ways. On the one hand, it could be a research thesis, mainly following your personal research under supervision of one or more colleagues, you develop a thesis, or you follow a professional training, and then on the basis of the result of that, you develop a thesis. With professional training, I mean the 10 of the credits that you are required to acquire in your path will be possible to obtain them not in the university, but by real life working in various municipalities or other local authorities or public-private bodies, agencies, and so on and so forth. We do not want you to look for yourself for a trainee. We have specific places that we provide to students to apply for. But of course, we also allow you to propose your own solution. This is very important because after acquiring knowledge, after testing the knowledge in exercise, practical exercise in real life that we give you, then you have the opportunity to really going into the practice. And this is the first professional experience that you can write on your CV and so on. So the professional thesis is based on the activity that you have here. As far as the assessment is concerned, we have a regular kind of assessment, like examination that could be oral or written or online in this specific period, and so on and so forth. But given the fact that you will have to develop a lot of projects and exercise, we will also evaluate your work and not only how you answer to questions. So we will evaluate your project. We will ask you to present the result of your work. We will ask you to write essays and so on and so forth. This prepares you also for real life after education, meaning that in your future activity, you will have to actually develop a project and to be able to defend it in front of your committent. Beside all these activities that I mentioned, very important in our curriculum are also the extra teaching activities, meaning that not necessarily they will provide you with a mark, but will contribute to enlarge your perspective on what spatial planning is and how it works. As I say, spatial planning is very context dependent, so very important it is to understand the challenges that are to be faced in other places and the way in which these challenges are faced by people operating in different cultural and institutional environments. So basically every year we bring our students in study tour to many other places, many places in Europe, but also outside Europe, like we've been in Tokyo, for instance, we've been in Berlin, we've been in Delft, we've been in Paris and so on. This happens, as I say, for site visit, for study tour, for summer school, for graduation studios, for virtual exchange program, like for instance, we have the University DePaul in Chicago. So we do have a lot of activities that are very international in very in their essence and bring you in touch with our reality, which is essential if you want to study and if you want to be a planner in the future. Yeah, it's not like if you are learning a subject that can be learned just on your desk. It's important to be on the field and to meet other people and to try to understand how things are dealt with in different other places. And we try to provide you with opportunity to do so. Besides that, you can also decide to study abroad one full semester. You can do that with the under the Erasmus program, yeah, with by choosing with many different destinations that Polytechnic offers. As far as our curriculum is concerned, we offer 13 other destinations in Europe by prestigious universities, 4 in America, 4 in Asia, and 1 in Oceania. Some of them are among the top-ranked universities in the world. Politecnico di Torino is one of those, but University of Tokyo is also, UCL is, Delft University of Technologies, and so on and so forth. You can do this as one semester abroad, or you can also decide to develop your thesis abroad. Of course, under specific condition that you will have, of course, to ask to explore with our office, there is also the possibility to obtain financial support to do that. I'm moving forward with the slide. I don't know if you see the following slide. Yes. Okay, here in this slide, you have an example of some of the graphical elaboration we will require to do and you will learn how to do. The point is that planners deal with space, and they have to know space, they have to try to understand space, but they also have to learn how to represent it. Yeah, and so for geomatic and GIS technology, spatial visualization programs, you will learn how to actually represent data that are georeferenced on space. And these are just some of the examples, of course, there are much more. You have the link on the bottom, a link at Polito Web Thesis. This link is sending you to explore thesis, master thesis that has been produced by our former students. If you go there, you will see what a thesis in planning looks like and what you will be required to do. What about careers? Well, when you finish, the graph on the right tells you that you're most likely to find a job in 1 year. 94%, 0.7, so almost 95% of our students graduate, find their first job after 1 year after graduation. Of course, not all the jobs are permanent. Some of them are mostly are trainees. Some of them are 1 or 2 year contracts and so on and so forth. But still, it starts to fill lines in your curriculum. It starts to give you practical experience, which is something that in the practice is really required. As far as what you can do after you graduate from spatial planning, well, you can do various different things. You can be a regional and landscape planner. You can deal with actual plans, writing strategies, developing zoning plan in the practice. And this is something that you may imagine. But you can also do other things, like, for instance, deal with spatial data, to become an expert of spatial analysis, so to provide a way to visualize information that will be then useful useful to administration or to other bodies in order to take decisions. So you are supporting decision making. Oh, I don't know why, but this slide has moved. I didn't press anything. So I have to go back. I'm sorry for this. Okay. And the third option is that you could be an urban manager. Urban manager is not a category, is not a category of profession. It mainly refers to people that in their profession deal with complex processes that have a spatial dimension. For instance, if a part of the city has to be redeveloped following the shutting down of a number of factories, the municipality and the number of private actors decide to join forces and resources in order to put together a strategy, a program for redeveloping this, there is a need of a figure that manages the whole process. This is what we call urban manager, a person that knows how much this intervention will cost, how much resources they will reward in the end, and what are the needs that require the hinging all the intervention together. So the best way to represent it for me is a manager of complex problems that have a spatial dimension. Well, our university, you already know that if you want to apply to Polytechnic di Torino, but also our Master of Science are quite renowned and ranked worldwide. Polyto is indeed a top university, yeah, as is proved by the QS World University Ranking, and it is the 33rd university in the world in the subject of architecture and the built environment, that are exactly where planning is located. Most important is 14th by graduate employment rate, meaning it provides you quite a good opportunity to find a job. When it comes to our specific Master of Science, it has been awarded a certificate of quality by the Association of European Schools of Planning. The Association of European Schools of Planning, in short, ESOP, is the main association dealing with planning education in Europe, and I would say worldwide, and it provides certificate of quality, like a stamp of quality on specific Master of Science that are evaluated as of excellence. And it is the case for our Master of Science, and this is true also for the bachelor degree that precedes this one. It seems the students like us. Yeah, of course, they provide their opinion in anonymous questionnaire, so they are not forced to say that they like us, so their opinion could be quite sincere. It seems that they like us in the sense that 97% of the assessment of the students of our courses are above the average of Polito. What do they like from our courses are mostly three things. The first one is the favorable student-teacher ratio, meaning that our Master of Science doesn't enroll 200 people per year. It enrolls between 25 and 50. We would like to have a bigger number, but these numbers, I think they are very good for what we do because we work really with students. Each course has one or two professors and two or three assistants for 25, 30, 35 students. It means that each student is known by name, his skill, pros and cons. Weakness and strength are known by the people that teach them. So anything can be arranged somehow during the process. Yeah? If you have some trouble in learning specific subjects and so on, there is always the room for directly speaking with the professor and try to find solution. And this is something that is very liked. Another thing that is very much appreciated is the professionalizing approach, meaning that we don't only teach you and make you learn on books, but we tell you that we want you to apply the knowledge that you acquire. So we challenge you with real life practice. We try to throw you in a swimming pool and see if you are able to swim. If you don't, you don't drown, we try to pick you up again. A third thing that is very much appreciated is the high number of students from other universities, both from Italy and around the world. This is not typical. Yeah? In our course, the majority of the people don't come from the bachelor in Polytechnico in Planning. They come from Bachelor of Science in many different subjects from many other universities. Yeah? Could be Bachelor of Science in Planning, but also in Environmental Engineer, also in Sociology, also in Architecture, also in Economy, also in Forestry, also in Geography, and so on and so forth. So this richness in terms of background and in terms of cultures is one of the most important things. As I say, planning in co is context dependent. So in order to learn how planning works all around the world and what the challenges are, then to meet with people that come from other places and they have different background is enriching. It's not only there in the background, it is an integral part of your education. This is exactly what is shown in this slide. Yeah, is where the people that subscribe to our Master of Science in the last years come from. Yeah, from 12 universities in Italy, from as many as 16 universities all around the world. We are not talking about Erasmus exchange here. Eh? We are talking mostly about people that subscribe to the whole master program, which is very, very interesting to have such a multicultural environment that you will sort of jump in and be surprised from. What about the application? Well, application need to be managed for the apply link of Politecnico. As I say, you will need to have a Bachelor of Science in planning, but also related subject. As I mentioned, architecture, geography, sociology, engineering, and so on and so forth, but also other. You will have to apply and see how your previous curriculum fits with our framework, and you will be required maybe to take some eligible courses in order to catch up with some subject. I'm talking here to people that would like to apply to the English curriculum. If you have an Italian qualification, you are either directly admitted or admitted from the interview. If you have a foreign qualification, meaning not taken from an Italian university, you have to fill in an application form. The deadline are as follows. You have all the links. Yeah, so you still have time for the June window. And if you are from an Italian with an Italian qualification and so on, you still have a lot of time for the September window. So make sure that you do not lose this deadline. Yeah? Try to get in on the apply page of Politecnico as soon as possible if you want to apply and figure out how to do it. Yeah? Don't get to the last minute. Of course, this is something that I need to present you, is the situation we are living. It is extremely challenging now. It is already one semester that we are teaching remotely. And this will happen also in the next semester and most likely for the whole year. Some activity may be made in presence, but there will be sure guaranteed the possibility to follow online. Politecnico page, web page, provide all the information on this, and you can ask further information and question to the ticketing service. What I can assure you, and this is important, I think, is that you will not be guinea pig of online teaching. It will not be a test what we will do the next semester. Politecnico has already been doing this teaching online since one full semester. We have been managing courses, studio and atelier, graduation, exams, everything online, and it worked. It worked very well, and we are sure that it will work very well also in the next semester. Said that, we are not an online university. Politecnico di Torino is a university which is not comparable to the online university that you could see advertisement on TV. Yeah? It's one of the top-ranked universities in the world and provide high-quality education. The fact that the pedagogical activity are now online is only due to the emergency. And we plan to go back to physical education as soon as the situation will allow us to do it without risk. For any question you may have, please apply. Open a ticket at our architecture registration office. You can find the link here. You can find the link on the website and within the material we have on the website. They will have all information concerning bureaucracy and administration. So if you don't know which certificate you need to submit, then you ask them. If you don't know exactly how to get the visa, you ask them. If you have a question about the subject that are taught in our course, you ask us. And with us, I mean the people you can find here with you and in this slide. Yeah, me, myself are here, Giancarlo Cotella. Also, Claudia Cassatella is the main responsible figure for this Master of Science, plus all the other people. Our email is name.surname@polito.it. You can drop us an email whenever you like. Please, in every email, add me in copy, as I'm responsible for orienteering, promotion, and vocational activity for this Master of Science. By concluding, please follow us on Instagram. We have an Instagram page in which Federica Bonavero Make great effort every day to put all the interesting activities and information that we have. So just follow us. It's planning.polito. It is very nice. It presents nice stories and nice images. And I will say, I just close with a picture of the place, the Valentino campus, where our activities will be located, at least some of them. So just join us. Do your application, and I hope to see you all either physically or most likely for the beginning virtually on the 28th of September. I will say that's all. We still have around 10 minutes for questions from your side. Thank you very much for your attention, and I hope we will meet soon. Wow, there is really a lot of questions.
No, well, the previous conversation about how difficult it is to work online, or how is it possible to work in group online? And I try to give answers according to the experience that I did this semester. I had the two studios, so this means that okay. Exercises, planning exercises, analysis, interpretation of sites, etc., working in group, and the students, well, they reacted very quickly to the new circumstances, and thanks to all the different tools that we have, they are able to discuss and prepare their work in groups, which is part of the training that we provide. As planners, you will always work in group with different experts of different disciplines or with your team. So the ability to work in group is relevant. And I know that some students coming from different backgrounds, mostly from engineering, they are more used to study individually different subjects. But as I was saying, this modality is part of the skill that you have to acquire as a planner. So that's why we don't re renounce to this modality even in these days. What activities will be held in presence? We will see. We will see. So, first of all, as soon as we will be able to come back in classes, we may, for instance, review small group of students, review the work of a small group of students, interact with for other thesis, for instance, or for instance, guided site visits. We usually organize site visits every year in some urban spaces or natural environments according to the subject, or meeting with, and maybe we can organize a site visit with small groups to see intervention on the in the cities. This kind of activities, step by step. We will see step by step. So what we will do is to guarantee, in any case, didactics, both for those who will be in Torino and for those who cannot reach Torino. So this is guaranteed for the entire year. And step by step, when we will realize it, that we can stay all together, we will recover some activities. Right, but it's not just for a polytechnical, for our entire life, I guess.
Yes, but if your worrying is about the fact that at certain point activity will restart and you will be forced to come here like packing your bag in 2 days and join us, no, this is not the case. For the full year, Politecnico guarantees equal opportunity of education to all the people that subscribe, wherever place they come from, meaning that you will be allowed to follow the full year online if you wish. This is what they say. This is what they say. It is allowed. There is the point that because of the fact that maybe someone that subscribe come from a place where he or she is not allowed to move, then for the full year it is guaranteed that there will be the chance to attend online for at least 1 year. But
And to
then
give the exams online.
and to give all the exams online. Of course, if the situation will allow us to do some physical activity, meaning meeting, as Claudia says, small group of students for revision, then we will try to do it. But if, for instance, one person will be located in a country in which the border are not open yet, then this person will not be excluded from the activity, but there will be opportunity for this person to participate to these activities virtually. This is very important to say. Nobody will be excluded or penalized for any reason if they continue to attend online for 1 year at least.
At the same time, we hope to add step by step further opportunities as opportunities to do things together.
Okay, there is another question. So, for those who can attend classes, is there any opportunity to have physical activity? This is my personal opinion. I don't see this too much in the first semester. Maybe it will start to happen in the second one. But this is something that we cannot provide you with any clear information with any trustable information from our side, because this will really depends on the pandemic. It depends if the pandemic will finish, it will continue diminishing as it seems now, or if it will be a new outbreak in.